Coupable is a French film directed by Lajdi. It takes place in Montfermeil, which is the area where Victor Hugo wrote his incredibly famous novel Les Misérables, and has now become what we would call in French a cité. Maybe you could translate that by a project housing area. It's basically become a ghettoized community that's plagued by social violence and poverty. The movie starts off by operating as an almost observational documentary into that community. The way we're brought into that community is done in a very classic, tried and true way. There is a new member of the police force that integrates the police squad that operates within Montfermeil. And so this person acts as a surrogate for the spectator as we, along with him, discover this new world and are presented with this incredibly diverse cast of characters. The film opens with sequences shot during France's World Cup victory in 2018, and it starts off with scenes of joy and people all dressed in blue, white, and red with French flags everywhere. It presents us with this moment of joy and national community, which of course is temporary and fleeting. That's essentially what the film is about, presenting a small microcosm that is representative of French society and presenting its disintegration over a hot summer day, with influences from Spike Lee's Do the Right Thing to Mathieu Kassovitz's La Haine to even something like Gareth Evans' The Raid by the end. But the film elevates itself beyond its prestigious references. It is, in and of itself, an incredibly remarkable achievement, and has, really in my opinion, many qualities, but two very strong ones. The first one is its extremely fair representation of that community. No character is good or evil, no situation is black or white. Every character is profoundly human and flawed, or every flawed character also has redeeming qualities. The character, for example, that is the most representative of the audience and acts, or at least says, the most moral things throughout the film does act at some points in self-motivated and selfish ways. This non-Manichaean, non-binary vision of La Cité emphasizes the idea that the situation is so volatile, so rotten, so complicated, that it's not something that can really be changed through individual action. It's part of a broader historical and societal context, one that inevitably sparks tremendous amounts of violence. The other great quality the film has is aesthetic, and it's in that sort of observational documentary feel. It really helps establish this area as a real place, these characters as real people. Nothing in the movie ever feels fake or put on. A great many number of sequences in the film are shot from inside the police car looking out, just driving by and just getting brief glimpses of the population from inside the moving vehicle. And I thought that was a really powerful choice because it reminded me of those documentaries or those movies that you see in Iraq or in Afghanistan where they're shot from inside the Humvee and you're with the soldiers looking outside. It really helped establish the situation and this area as almost a war zone, as almost an occupied territory. It really feeds into the paranoia and the fear that the police have of the population and the population have of the police. And sometimes that's warranted and sometimes it's not, and that's what's really, really powerful. I'm going to move on to spoilers, so if you haven't seen the movie yet, I would highly recommend that you watch the film before listening to the rest of the review. It makes the ending feel all the more gritty and intense and inevitable. And what's really impressive about that ending is, again, how it doesn't fall into that stereotypical the population versus the government or the ghetto versus the police. Rather, it's about youth seizing power. It's about realizing that it's not just the police force that's corrupt or that's problematic, it's the entire system. It's actually everyone within the community that actually benefits from the system, that actually has authority. The drug dealers, the police, the mob bosses, and to a certain extent, even the religious figures within the community. And so ultimately, the film doesn't devolve into a discourse about national or racial identity, but rather a revolution against authority. So as always, thanks very much for watching the video. Please be sure to hit the like button if you like the review. Subscribe if you're new, and until next time, see ya.